Yes, but I've got a conference to attend.
But do I have to go to Grandad's?
We've already discussed this. It's for the Eastman contract. You have to go. It's 2 days. Deal with it.
2 days? Really?
You'll be fine. Stay there tonight. I'll pick you up Friday. You'll just have to deal with it.
But Grandad never even says anything, and I guess Lance will be there.
Well, I guess so. He pays rent. He's their lodger.
He's an arsehole.
He may be annoying, but he's helped Grandad out loads. You just have to deal with it. His dad knew Grandad for years, they helped each other out, they're long-term family friends. So you're just going to have to put up with it, it's only for a couple of days.
But he is actually an arsehole.
Family grew up in the area, you're just going to have to deal with it.
Deal with the arsehole. Got it.
What about Lizzie, your little cousin? She's nice, isn't she?
All she does is draw. Not that I don't appreciate the artistic talent, but still.
Look. We just have to deal with this. You're not old enough to be home on your own. It's a 2-day conference. It was different if it was just half a day, but it's not. So we're just going to have to deal with this situation. Get over it. 2 days will fly past.
All I can say is thank God for music. Hi, Grandad. Wonderful. Hi, Lizzie. How are you?
Fine.
You really like drawing, don't you?
No.
Sorry, would you like to play a game?
Maybe not now, but maybe later.
Oh, okay.
Is Sammy Whammy here yet?
Oh, great.
Ah, oh, it's little Sammy Whammy come to stay for a couple of days.
Hello, Lance.
And who are those jackasses you've got on your shirt? Black Veil Brides? Like a bunch of arseholes to me.
And you'd know all about arseholes.
Think you're pretty tough, don't you? Listening to your rock music makes you a really tough girl. Oh, look at me, big tough Sam.
Not really.
I know something that will scare you. I know something that will make you scream like a little baby.
Oh yeah? What's that?
An urban legend from around here about a man long ago called Solomon Grundy.
Great name.
Story says he was 7 feet tall and had arms like the trunk of a tree.
Okay.
It's said that he did some bad things to people in this town. Really bad things. All the townspeople had enough. They all clubbed together and they all ambushed Solomon Grundy. So they all crept up on Solomon Grundy while he was sleeping and they slit his throat. But it didn't work. Grundy was still alive.
Damn.
So they shot him 4 times, right in the face. But he still wasn't dead.
So then what did they do?
They hung him. They strung him up to the tallest tree they could find and they heard his neck crack.
Ow.
That big old bastard was still not dead.
Shit, really? Then what?
They dragged Grundy to the deepest, darkest, muddiest river they could find and they threw him in it. And big old Grundy, being so big, sank right to the bottom like a stone and his lungs filled up with water and they burst.
Right, so that was the end of Solomon Grundy?
He was dead, but it wasn't the end. Children in the town started disappearing after that day. It was Grundy, seeking his revenge.
Holy crap.
People kept seeing the shape of a monstrous man lumbering through the town at night, and by the morning, another little child would be gone. Grundy dragged him to the swamp to suffer the same fate that he'd suffered.
So, what did they do?
It was the children that had the answer. They made up a song about Solomon Grundy. All the children in the town would gather together at night, hold hands and close their eyes and sing the song, praying that Solomon Grundy would be appeased and he wouldn't take them away.
Did it work?
Yeah. They say that after that, the kids stopped disappearing and Grundy was never seen again.
Cool story.
Story ain't a bloody story, it's the truth.
Sure.
About 4 miles from here is Cemetery Hill. That's where Grundy's supposed to be buried with all the other townspeople. But he's not really there.
Really? So where is he then?
About a mile from where you're sitting right now is an old deep dark lake. The same deep dark lake where they threw Grundy all them years ago.
You're kidding me, right?
No, I ain't kidding. Grundy's at the bottom of that lake right now with all the bodies of those children he took down with him. They say that some nights you can hear the spirits of the children playing around the lake. The children of Solomon, they call them.
That's creepy.
Creepiest part of all is that he never did get his revenge on all the townspeople because of that song. Maybe Grundy's gonna come crawling out of that lake one more time. Maybe Solomon Grundy is gonna come looking for you! Ha ha ha, got ya!
Great. So, what are the words then?
What words?
The Solomon Grundy song? How does it go?
I don't know. What do I look like? An encyclopedia?
Arsehole.
What'd you say?
Nice hat.
Yeah, it's mine and you can't have it.
Dickhead. This for 2 days? Really? You've got to be fucking kidding me. This can't be the lake. That story was bullshit, wasn't it? He can't really be down there. Okay, well that's enough for one night. I'm going.
Solomon Grundy, born on a Monday, married on Tuesday, you have awakened.
Solomon Grundy.
Lizzie? Is that you? Holy shit. The story really got to me. Shit. Forget about Sam. Just go back to sleep.
Solomon Grundy.
What the fuck? Well, no more sleep for me tonight.
Okay, Solomon, let's see if you're actually here. Solomon, where are you buried?
There's no grave for Solomon here.
Oh, hello. I'm sorry, I didn't see you there.
There's no grave for Solomon here.
So Solomon Grundy's real? Have you lived around here long?
I've been here for a long time.
So you know all about Solomon and the horrible things that he did?
I know all about Solomon, but he never did anything bad. Not while he was alive.
But I was told...
Solomon arrived in this town and found a nice place to live. He found a job. And he met a lovely young lady. They were to be wed that very morning. That very morning, the townsfolk murdered him.
But why? Why would they murder him?
There were a lot of churches in this town. It was a very religious area. The people lived off the land and grew their food. Every year, the fields had given them plenty to eat and sell. And every year it was, until Solomon came.
They blamed Solomon? For the harvest?
People believed that the only thing that was different was the new man in town. He was wearing his wedding suit when they murdered him.
So Solomon wasn't bad at all?
Solomon was kind and gentle. He played with the town's children and fell in love with the mayor's daughter.
So what happened to her?
They locked her in the church. When she found out what they'd done, she took her own life. Her heart was broken.
That's awful. So the next part of the story, about him coming back and taking the children, is that true as well?
Many of the children went missing after that day.
So, is he really at the bottom of that lake?
Oh yes, dear. He's down there. He's waiting.
Waiting? For what?
Waiting for the last of the children of Solomon. Are you from around these parts, young lady?
My ancestors are.
Oh, I see.
Oh, well, thanks for the help. I need to go. What was your name? Oh, she's gone. It's real. Solomon Grundy's real.
Solomon Grundy, born on Monday, christened on Tuesday, married on Wednesday. You have awakened, Solomon Grundy.
Lizzie, where did you hear that song?
A little boy told me, in my dream.
This little boy?
Yes, he was in my dreams. We played games. He told me there were bad men was coming. I need to learn this song. The boy told me if I sing the song, the bad man won't hurt me.
When did the boy say the bad man was coming?
Tonight.
What are the words to the song?
Solomon Grundy.
Born on a Monday.
Christened on Tuesday. Married on Wednesday. You have awakened Solomon Grundy.
Where's Uncle Lot?
He's at work.
We need to go now. Come on, we have to go now. Go in there and don't come out.
Solomon Grundy.
No matter what you hear, do not come out.
Born on a Monday. Married on Tuesday. Awaken, Solomon Grundy.
Lizzie? Solomon Grundy, born on a Monday, prison on a Tuesday, married on Wednesday. Now you've awakened Solomon Grundy. Lizzie? Not the one. And who is? You're gonna come live with me now. Okay, Lizzie?
Okay, Sam. Can we do drawing?
Yeah, I think we can manage that. Hi Sam, hi Lizzie, how was your stay?
Oh, fine. Mum, we need to talk about our ancestors.
So Lizzie's gone to live with Sam, eh? They're welcome to her. The little kid used to freak me out anyway. Who the bloody hell's that? Who's knocking this time of night?